What's up, guys? It's Chuck from Brady Adventures, and I'm super, super excited that we just got our Roofnest Falcon.
Whatever this is, no, this is definitely a first for me. Wow. It's pretty cool.
Just pop up in there.
Yeah.
Go to sleep.
Wow. That's something else.
This thing is super slick. It is very, very cool. It's cooler in person than it is in pictures. The box definitely came damaged, so I did a really good inspection of it. The corner of it was pretty bad off, but it looks like there was no contact there. Something I didn't see when I first inspected it was, looks like a forklift hit it down here, and you'll see that kind of thing on a lot of freight deliveries. And it definitely dinged up the bottom a little bit, but it's really just a scratch. I can't stress enough, when you get something from a shipping company, to take the time to take pictures of the box, open it up slowly, take pictures as you go, every little bit of damage, and mark it on the invoice before you sign.
For a long time, I had ruled out rooftop tents. I was looking at the bigger ones that would fit my whole family. A lot of those fold out. They take quite a bit of time to set up, and the advantages over a ground tent just weren't there for me. More recently, I realized I'll probably be taking more trips with just friends or maybe with my son, and decided that having a rooftop tent that I could set up really quickly and take down really quickly would be a really nice thing to have. I ended up deciding on the Roofnest Falcon for a number of reasons.
Initially, I looked at the Sandpiper, and I thought that was really cool. It had the load bars on top. I really wanted to be able to do that because I needed to move so many things from my rack somewhere else in the rig. I didn't really consider the Falcon until I started trading some emails with Roofnest, and they told me some of the things that they thought I would like about this, and I decided to go ahead and go with it. And let me tell you a few reasons why. Number one, attaching solar to this roof is gonna be super easy. Roofnest also sells load rails, so I'm gonna be able to get some things up on the roof here that I had on my roof rack before. So I really like the low profile. This thing is so sleek. It's 6.5 inches thick. And when you see it in person, it's really amazing. I cannot wait to see this on the Land Cruiser. They have these slots on the side, and I had seen their latches and things that go on. Use the T-slot slider, a plate, kind of like a Rhino rack uses. And when I talked to Roofnest, they informed me that it was an M8 bolt size. The very same hardware that I use for all of my front runner roof rack applications will fit right in here. I can slide an M8 bolt that has the 13 millimeter wide head on it, just like I would on the front runner. There we go. And tighten it up, and there you go. That really opens me up the ability for me to mount pretty much anything I want here, and I can be a little bit creative. I don't have to worry about just relying on Roofnest products, although they just did come out with a set of brackets that are, I think, primary purposes for awnings that will actually clear this strut. They look really, really nice. Setup time on this thing is amazing. Undo the latches on the back. Give it a little push up and it pops right up and is essentially ready to go. And all you really need to do after that is either put the rods in for your rain fly or roll this stuff up if you've got good weather. And takedown really doesn't take that much longer. It's mainly the additional step of getting all this fabric tucked in so your rubber seal makes good contact on the bottom frame here. So Roofnest has two sizes. This one, which is the standard, and then they have an XL, which is wider. One of the reasons I picked this particular one is it fits into my rack perfectly, and it shouldn't have any problems interfering with my shadow on, which is gonna be on the driver's side, mounted directly to the front runner rack. I would have preferred to have the XL just for the room inside. It would definitely have had some interference with the shadow on. The way that I'm gonna mount this right now with the front runner mounting brackets that I have, it's gonna be sitting less than 1/4 inch above the edge of the front runner, so it should look really, really slick. So one of the things I haven't mentioned is price. These are not inexpensive pieces of gear, and it's definitely a premium modification for your rig. But one of the things about Roofnest is, with what you get for the amount of money, it's very, very competitive,
And make sure when you're comparing to some of the competitors that you look at it with shipping included. Roofnest includes shipping in their price. So in the end, there's a number of reasons why I picked the Roofnest Falcon. The quick and easy setup and takedown, the low profile, the accessory channels, our ability to get our solar mounted on top, and the fact that this was gonna fit perfect on our roof rack. And when you combine that with the price point compared to the competitors, this was the perfect rooftop tent for us. We're super, super excited about this rooftop tent. We're gonna be bringing you a bunch of videos in the coming months. We're gonna do a quick one where we walk around and show you all the features and give you an idea of how everything looks. And then we're gonna get this installed on top of the vehicle. We're gonna get out there and try it out. We're gonna do a lot of camping with it in the spring and summer. And if you enjoyed the video, please give us a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and keep an eye out for all those videos. Thanks a lot for watching, guys.
If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up and consider subscribing to our channel. And always feel free to leave us any comments or questions that you might have.